Most awaited topic, and today's topic is tenses. This is the topic that I've received most of the comments for, that one, please do a video on tenses. So we'll be doing this. Before getting into this, I'm going to tell you something, that there is nothing to be like scared of tenses. This is a very simple topic that you will understand properly, and you will never fail if you understand properly. So I will try my best to explain you this topic step by step so that it becomes easy for you. So in this video, we'll be just discussing the first type of tense, that is the present tense. So before moving forward, we must know that tenses are categorized into three main categories: the present tense, past tense, and the future tense. Now, what is present, what is past, and what is future? This is the most important thing that you need to know. And right when you know it, you'll be able to categorize the tenses and use the right forms while speaking. Because our speaking, the way we speak English, is mostly based on our knowledge of tenses. So, it is very important to have knowledge of tenses. So, present tense. Now, present tense is something that is happening right now in the very present moment, or any action that have started in the past. Know that like when we talk about these present tense, past tense, and future tense, they all have subcategories. There are four subcategories under all of them, so in all we'll be having 12. So starting with the present tense, we'll be first of all talking about the simple. Now guys, just be very careful about one thing, that we are not going to cram anything, we are just going to learn like very easily. I'll give you like, just maths mein formulas hota hai, I'll give you some formulas for these tenses, and that's how we are going to roll. So just understand that when we talk about simple present tense, how and when it is used. Simple present tense is always used when you are stating facts or your habits or your routine work. For example, if I ask you, what time do you wake up? You will say that, ma'am, I wake up at 7 a.m. So that's your habit, that's your same routine. So you will use the present tense. Now, many children get confused, like, ma'am, which form of the verb are we going to use and when we are going to use? So the simple answer to that question is, just remember, when we are talking about the simple present tense, just you need to know is the formula, is the first form of the verb. This is what you're going to use. So yeah, it's the first form of the verb, or it is also called the basic form or the root form. Like we know verbs, verb is any action word. So the first form is always used in the simple present tense. Simple present tense is used to state facts and habits, as I've told you. So for example, if I say the sun sets in the west or the sun rises in the east, these are the facts that I'm stating. Honesty is the best policy, like this. So whenever I'm stating habits or facts, or anything that is, you know, just that indicates your regular routine work, we are going to use this tense. So that is the first form of the verb. Let us read the examples. The sun sets in the west. So what is the verb here? It sets is the verb. So you will see that the first form of the verb is being used. He travels a lot. Again, he travels a lot. Rosie lives in Delhi. So you will see that we are using the first form. Now there is an addition to this. The formula is first form of the verb plus s or es. Like, are you going to add s or es to the verb or not? So let's see, whenever you have the singular subject, like he and Rosie and the sun, they are all singular in nature. We are just adding s or es, we will add. But right when your subject changes into plural, let's say they. I will not say they lives in Delhi, I will say they live in Delhi. The negative sentences out of them, you will say they do not live in Delhi, like that. And Rosie does not live in Delhi, like that. Does not and do not. We use does not and do not in order to make the sentences negative. So again, if your subject is singular, you are always going to use tense, that is present continuous tense. Now you will ask, ma'am, what is the difference between simple present tense and present continuous tense? Now present continuous tense has a word continue. Continue is something that is just continuing. Abhi tak wo cheez khatam nahi hui hai. The action is still continuing. The present continuous tense is used to describe an action that is happening right now. It's happening right now. For example, I am teaching. happening right now or an action that is going to take place near future. Like I am going to the market. It is going to take place in the near future. Like it is not taking place now, but in the near future. So like I've told you that we'll be doing some formulas. So formula for present continuous tense will be is, am, are plus ing form of verb. Now you will see that here it is a slash. Now why is it a slash? That we are going to use one of these. Either we'll use is or am or are, but we are definitely going to add. So we are going to see कि हम is किसके साथ लगाएंगे, am किसके साथ लगाएंगे and are किसके साथ लगाएंगे. So is always used with the singular subject. If I say is always used with she or he or any other subject that is singular in nature. Are is always used with the subjects that are plural in nature. And am is very evident. We are always going to use am with I. For example, I am leaving for the market, right? So I hope this is clear and we'll be moving on to some examples of this tense. Now these are the examples, just note it very carefully that with the plural subjects you will use are, singular subjects is. Now they are waiting for us at the restaurant. Now the subject is plural, they. The subject over here is they. So you will see that the verb is wait. So how is it formed? Just look at it. So the formula was is, am or are plus ing form of verb. So you will see that this formula is going to apply in all of the sentences. So in the very first sentence, they are waiting, ing form of the verb wait. They are waiting for us at the restaurant. They are already waiting. Okay. A nightingale, it's again a singular subject. A nightingale is singing. Singular subject takes is from this. Is singing in the woods. And if I use the subject I am coming to your place. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. And if we talk about negative sentences in present continuous tense, it is also very easy. How are you going to do that? If I ask you to convert them into negative, so it is very easy. What you'll do, you'll just simply add not. Let's see how. They are waiting for us at the restaurant. They are not waiting for us at the restaurant. A nightingale is not singing in the woods, right after the helping verb. You are going to add not. And I am not coming to your place, right? I hope this is clear to you. And if we are talking about interrogative sentences, if I ask you, just convert them into interrogative sentences. So now for forming interrogative sentences, we are going to take the help of helping verbs. Helping verbs are, is, and am. So now we know that we are just going to change the placement. For example, if I ask you to convert this sentence into an interrogative sentence, so how are we going to do that? We're just going to take it in the front and we'll say, are they waiting for us at the restaurant? Is a nightingale singing in the woods? And again, am I coming to your place? It is like as easy as that. You're just going to place the helping verbs initially, okay? So that's how you can form the negative sentences as well as the interrogative sentences in this tense. I hope that this is clear to you. Now we'll be moving on to that is present perfect tense. Now present perfect tense, when are we going to use it? Present perfect tense is used to indicate an action that has been completed just now. It talks about an action that you've just completed. We have just completed learning present continuous tense, like that. Okay, action that started some time ago and is still continuing till that time. I've just completed, okay? So now the formula for the same is, what is the formula? You just need to remember the formula. So the formula is has slash have means has or have plus the third form of the verb. That means you're going to use the third form of the verb. You're just going to play with has or have accordingly. So has you will use with the singular subjects. Have you will use with the plural subjects. So let us see the examples now. Ram has finished correcting his homework. work. So now you see the main verb over here is finished. So the third form of finish is finished. Now you have to select from has or have. So Ram, since it is a singular subject, you are going to select has. We use has. So Ram has finished correcting his homework. Now we have, again, we will see that we is a plural subject. With the plural subjects, we are going to use have. We have known this family for many years. So known, the third form. So know, new, and known. So known is the third form. That's what you're using, this family for many years. I have been ill since Tuesday, which means I'm still ill right now, you know. So that's what this tense indicates. Just say abhi tak continue, or I'm still not feeling well. That's what it says. I have. So now you must be thinking that I is singular, but ma'am, why are we using have with I? So whenever we talk about English grammar, we use this as a plural subject and we use plural verbs with it. Like I have, we never say I has, we always say I have. Okay, so that is the way. Now if we talk about negative sentences, formation of negative sentences in present perfect tenses, again very easy. You're just going to add not. For example, Ram has not finished correcting his homework. We have not known this family for many years, and I have not been ill since Tuesday. That's how you will make the negative sentences. Now let's talk about interrogative sentences. Again, it is very easy. What are you going to do? You are going to take help of these helping verbs. The helping verbs are has and have and again have. So what in the interrogative sentences we are supposed to do? We're supposed to do like bring them in the beginning. For example, has Ram finished correcting his homework? Have we known this family for years, for many years? Have I been ill since Tuesday? It's very easy. You're just going to use the helping verbs, bring them forward, and that's how you can make interrogative sentences. I hope that this is clear, and now we'll move on of tense. So now our next and last type of tense in the present tenses are the present perfect continuous tense. So whenever the word continuous comes in like in the tenses, just remember they're talking about the ing form. Why ing form? Because the action is still continuing. So let's read. Present perfect continuous tense shows an action that started in the past. It may have started in the past, but it is still continuing in the present time. We have been learning tenses. I can say that I have started teaching you tenses like minutes ago. It is already in the past, but it is still continuing. So anything that has started in the past but still continuing in the present, that's where we use this tense. So just like present perfect tense, you have to choose between has or have, and the form will be ing form. There is one addition, and that addition is of been, been. So this is the formula. If you want to note it down, just pause it and note it down. Has, have plus been plus ing form of the verb. I've been reading this book for a week now, which means I am still reading this book. Abhi ye end nahi hui hai baat. I am still reading this book. So I have been reading. You will see if you break the sentence, and you will see the formula being applied. Have, been, and ing form of the verb. This is how it works, right? So grandmother has. Grandmother is again a singular subject. So has is always used with the subject that is singular. I'm writing S for that. And have is always used for a subject that is plural in nature. So whenever we're talking about grandmother, single grandmother, so grandmother has not been feeling well lately. This is a negative sentence. If I want to say like in positive, I will just say the grandmother has been feeling well lately, which means she's already feeling well. And if I want to convert it into negative, I'll simply write not. Okay, the next one is Samira has been living in New York since 2002. Again, Samira is a singular subject, so we are going to use has been living, which means that she is still living. That's why we are using this present form. So if we are going to convert these sentences into negative, you are not going to do anything like, you are not going to learn big formulas. Just add a not. For example, I have not been reading. Grandmother has not been feeling. And Samira has not been living. It is as simple as adding not, right? And if we talk about interrogative sentences, the rule is still the same. You have to just bring the helping verbs out of the sentence and frame them. Just like this one. Have I been reading this book for a week now? Just Don't forget to insert a question mark at the end if you are making an interrogative sentence. Has the grandmother not been feeling well lately? At the question mark. Has Samira been living in New York since 2002? Okay, so just in case if you're converting into interrogative sentences, don't forget to add a question mark instead of a full stop. So I hope present tenses are very clear to you guys. We'll be meeting in our next video. We will discuss past tense and the future tense. So till then, take care. Bye-bye.